In this illustration, we'll discuss about the oscillations of a rod hinged on a wall and supported by a string. Here you can see the figure shows a light rod attached with a bob of mass M is hinged at 1 and O and is also supported by a string of length L at the midpoint. And from equilibrium, if a rod is slightly displaced in the direction perpendicular to the plane of figure, we are required to find the oscillations of the system. Here we can draw the picture and analyze it in a different way like this. Here you can see if the rod is placed like this, which is given in the figure. And in this situation, we displace the bob in perpendicular direction like here. You need to understand that here I have displaced the bob inside the plane of this figure like this by an angle theta. Then the bob will oscillate in this manner, inside, outside and so on. And this length of a light rod is L. So here you can see when the bob would be oscillating in this manner, outside and inside by an angle theta or the angular amplitude theta. Here you can see the bob would be oscillating like a pendulum with suspension point here at point A from where the string is suspended. And we can see, if we consider this line A to mass M as a string, then you can imagine that this would be an oscillation like a simple pendulum with suspension point A and the string connected in an inclined fashion. So, if we consider G is acting on it in downward direction, along this line, the value of G would be G cos theta. If theta is this angle is theta. This length we can simply write as root of L square plus L square by 4 as this is L by 2. String is attached to the midpoint of this rod. So, we can consider the oscillations of bob similar to oscillations of a simple pendulum with the string length root of L square plus L square by 4 and oscillating under effective gravity, G effective can be given as G cos theta, because here you can see G cos theta is the effective force or effective acceleration under which the bob would be oscillating. So, in this situation, we can simply write time period of oscillation for this pendulum bob is equals to 2 pi root of this length, which is root of L square plus L square by 4 divided by G cos theta. And the value of cos theta also we can calculate from this triangle, which is given as L by root of L square plus L square by 4, which can be given as 2L by 4 L square plus small l square. So, we substitute the value of cos theta here. You can see the time period of oscillation of this bob can be given as root of this cos theta is 2L by root of 4L square plus L square. On simplifying, this will give us 4L square plus L square divided by, on substituting the value of cos theta, this will be 2GL into this 4GL. So, this will be the final result of the problem. Here we have evaluated this final result directly by considering it as an equivalent simple pendulum. However, you can also derive this result by the conventional method by displacing it by a small angle theta. Here you can see this angular amplitude theta is not same as this. This can be written as theta naught, the angular amplitude under which the bob is oscillating with respect to the hinged point O. And at an angle theta, we can find out the restoring torque, bringing the bob back, and using the concept of angular SHM, you can find out its angular frequency and get the same result. I'm leaving it as an exercise for you to derive this result by using the conventional method of simple harmonic motion.